To replace the power switch on bobsweep pet hair, you will need a Phillips head screwdriver, a flathead screwdriver, and a new power switch. Before starting any repair on Bob, turn his side power switch off and remove his dustbin. Then flip Bob over onto a flat surface and remove his main brush using the flathead screwdriver. Keep all removed screws and parts safely aside, as they may be needed for later reassembly. Use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove the 6 screws on Bob's underside that hold him together. 1 screw on each side of the front wheel. 1 screw to the right of the main brush motor. 1 screw on each side of the dustbin. The final screw is in the brush compartment. Bob's cover is no longer secured, so hold the top and bottom together as you carefully flip him back onto his wheels. Grip Bob's cover from the back and lift up to expose the mainboard. Slide the power inlet down and tuck it somewhere safe to avoid compressing its wires. To detach Bob's cover completely, disconnect 4 circuit plugs. 2 at the lower edge of the mainboard, near the wheels, and 2 more at the top edge, near the bumper. To remove the power switch, you must first uninstall the main board. Disconnect all remaining 12 circuit plugs from the main board. Press the small tab on each circuit plug and pull to disconnect. Remove 3 screws on the main board. Keep them aside for later reassembly. Now lift the main board out of Bob. Slide the power switch up out of its space located on Bob's side. The wires feed into Bob's battery compartment. Remove the screw holding the small wire cover. Then lift it up and keep aside. Gently pull the wiring through the gap and you'll see the circuit junction that connects the switch to Bob's battery. Pull to unplug. Now you can slide the new power switch straight down into the space on Bob's side. It will easily slide in when placed upright, with the off option on the bottom. Make sure the switch is turned to off before connecting it to the battery. Push the circuit junction into the side of the battery compartment. Then place the switch's wiring into the small indent on the battery compartment. Replace the wire cover so it lies flat, and install the screw that secures it. Now you're ready to replace the main board. Align the holes in the main board with the 3 screw posts on Bob's interior. Ensure that the main board sits flat before reinstalling the 3 screws. 1 screw goes in the middle of the main board, 1 in the top corner, and 1 in the lower corner. Now reconnect all the circuit plugs correctly. The order of plugs on the left side of the main board, from top to bottom, is a small plug with black and yellow wires, a plug with 2 pairs of twisted wires, a plug with multicolored wires for Bob's left wheel, a plug with blue and black wires. The order of plugs at the top of the main board, from left to right, is a small plug with red and green wires, a wide plug with multicolored wires, 2 empty spaces for now, and a small plug with black and orange wires in the top right corner. The order on the right side of the main board, from top to bottom, is a wide circuit plug for Bob's power switch, and a plug with black and orange wires for Bob's power inlet. For now, the bottom of the main board will have 2 open spaces to the very left. Then the order from left to right is a small circuit plug with a red wire, one more open space, a small plug with yellow wires, and a plug with multicolored wires on the very right. Now you're ready to begin reattaching the cover. Reattach all four circuit plugs connecting Bob's cover to the mainboard. Two connect to the top edge of the mainboard, and two more connect to the bottom edge. Remember to slide the power inlet back into its space on Bob's cover. Align the cover's edges precisely. Then flip Bob over onto a flat surface. Reinstall all six screws previously removed from Bob's underside. Ensure that no wires are compressed in the main brush compartment or visible at the edges of the bumper. If so, take a step back and lift the cover to tuck the wires into the appropriate spaces. Install the main brush and dustbin before your next use and Bob is completely reassembled. Turn the side power switch back on and congratulations! You've just replaced Bob's power switch. Happy cleaning!